So there's a lot of different ways to get financing for your real estate investment deals. And you know, Ian and I are very creative, and we recognize what's out there. We recognize some of the challenges there. And I know sometimes real estate investors say, oh, well, you know, I got some bank money, I got some of my own money, I got some hard money, I got some private money, I got a HELOC on my home.
IRA.
I'm not, IRA. I'm not 100% sure how to structure this deal. Well, those are easy things for us to structure. And you know, we like to use little hybrids or blends of certain funding sources if you don't have enough for one of them. Right? So example, I've always had this in the back of my mind, this theory of like, if you have $100,000 in cash and you have one deal for $100,000, why would you pay $100,000 in cash for one deal and then it limits you to buy any other additional deals? Now that's the only deal you're gonna do 1 year and you're a part-time investor, that's fine. But if you're doing multiple deals and you have 100 grand, split that up. Four deals at 25 grand a spot, 10 deals at 10 grand a spot, whatever the case is. So blend some of these financing types together. You know, utilize hard money companies like ourselves, hard money bankers, to get, you know, pretty full leverage on some of these things. 65% based off of your after repair value on one of these, and use your own cash as the closing cost. Instead of having, you know, buying it in cash, use the cash as a closing cost. Or get a gap funder in place, a private investor who wants to put up some money, either pay them a return or do a joint venture with them. So you can do that if you're getting bank financing, if you're getting a hard money lender. Obviously the hard money lender, just like a bank, is gonna wanna be a first mortgage. So some of these other ways, your own cash, private funds, whatever the case is, there's other ways to do that, but reach out to us. There's obviously also a lot of creative ways to utilize your 401k that, you know, a lot of people don't have a lot of liquid cash, but they have a lot of money in their 401k that's been sitting there around not doing much. There's ways to buy properties with your 401k and even leverage it up with a hard money loan that we will give you that's no personal guarantee, because you can't personally guarantee a self-directed IRA. Reach out to us at Hard Money Bankers and we can come up with creative ways to make it work.
Yeah, there's money in lots of different places, and I get people that ask me that all the time. And a lot of times I can sense the confusion that somebody might have is because maybe they have 25 grand here, 25 in an IRA, like Jay said, and 25 in a 401k. How do I use it? Should I use all my money at one time? You know, do I do a joint venture partnership with somebody? I get a question a lot of times. You know, I see a good deal, or I'll see somebody bringing a good deal, and I notice they're just not quite as cash liquid, or their cash is frozen somewhere at the moment. And I'll put them in touch with maybe somebody that I know is sitting around looking to partner with somebody and get into a deal that has maybe 50 or 100 grand. We make it work perfectly by blending their funding in with the borrower's funding in terms of that joint venture partnership, and then they can go ahead, similar to last week's or 2 weeks ago's video that we were discussing with that dealer we recently did. So
there's always creative ways to do it, cross-collateralizing other assets that you may have and taking out cash that way. So. Yeah. The rule of thumb is if you got a good deal and you've got some resources to work with, reach out to us and we'll figure out the best and most creative way to make something work.